Ladies and gentlemen, it is time for the latest expansion-packed episode of the Switch It Up show. And just like the name of my game today, ladies and gentlemen, our story goes on, because today I am joined by our friend Glenn.
I mean, you're joined by me every day. Almost every day.
Almost.
We have a good record here at the Switch It Up show.
We have a very solid record here at the Switch It Up show, ladies and gentlemen, considering the fact that for 6 months I was concussed, and for a few times, our friend Glenn was stuck with Destiny 2.
Hey, I mean, it demands attention.
That's right, it does. And hey, man, we all have these varying games that we love to play. Be sure to get at us. Let us know what you're doing during these trying times. But before we get into the two games we're talking about today, ladies and gentlemen, we gotta let these sweet beats ride. Onomatopoeia, ladies and gentlemen. Try my best to rhyme that name as weirdly as I can. And I will, because the story goes on, ladies and gentlemen. It's on Nintendo Switch. It is $5. That's right. A fill-up. That's exactly right. A $5 fill-up for the story goes on Nintendo Switch. And you get 25 gold coins when you purchase it digitally. A hack-and-slash adventure with heavy emphasis on exploration and dungeon crawling while using roguelite elements such as over-the-top items, permadeath, and random generation. You are the hero inside the storybook of an obsessed author pondering with his life's work. Explore repeating worlds, befriend a talking scarecrow, and swing your sword really fast while uncovering the true overarching adventure within. 50 plus various items. Every item is designed to shift the way you play, from standard buffs to combat enhancements to new ways of traversing puzzles. Items are made to work together and grant the player cool item combinations every time they play. A changing world. By progressing further and completing dungeons, the story introduces new bosses to defeat, tougher enemies to fight, and more complex environments to conquer. Pre-built dungeons. Within each randomly generated world is a matching, pre-existing dungeon that introduces new mechanics, enemies, and story elements into the main game. Stuff to hit! 20-plus bosses to defeat, dozens of enemies to grind out for gold. The works! A responsive soundtrack. Our original soundtrack adapts during gameplay to match the pace of battle. It is from... I can't seem to see the developer. That's a shame. Anyway, this game was a pretty good time, ladies and gentlemen. And let me tell you what, we get a lot of games like this, a lot of these procedurally generating dungeon crawlers where you get a bunch of different enemies, different types of... items, weapons, characters, it's all procedurally generated, and it's always changing, and you keep playing and grinding. You know how it goes, because there's tons of them. Found the developer, by the way. It's Scarecrow Arts. I'm very sorry that I missed you, but that is who it is, Scarecrow Arts. Again, very sorry. Game is good. I'll tell you what, it's good, ladies and gentlemen, because the music is on par. It's hot. And the Scarecrow, your Navi, if you will, your Jiminy Cricket type that is on your shoulder, is fairly funny. And not to toot my own horn, but the devs got at us on YouTube, which you can find down here in the show notes, and said that I did do their favorite voice for the Scarecrow yet. So kind of a big deal now. That said, ladies and gentlemen, the game is very, very repetitive. It is a lot like a lot of the games that you have already seen that do this. What does differ, though, is the animation and the humor. The humor is good, and the items are cool. So are the bosses. They're pretty fun to fight. I believe the first boss you fight is a fart cloud. That's right, a fart cloud. pretty fun. Pretty, pretty fun time. And when you die, it like they're cute characters, and when you die, it's just very flat out like, you are dead. I don't know. Something about the humor really makes this game stand out from the rest. As well as, like, I kind of want to say the characters, their animation style is a little leaning towards a Pendleton Ward, maybe a Steven Universe-esque, very Cartoon Network friendly. And I could see the story go on to an animated series. But ladies and gentlemen, because of all these things, I'm going to give The Story Goes On a 4 out of 5.
That's a good score, my man. Nothing wrong with a 4 out of 5, ever.
No. It's just that it gets to be so daunting coming across so many of these procedurally generated dungeon crawler roguelite games, because I feel like they're everywhere. But they're all not this cheap, and frankly, they're all not this funny. And you need something, I want to say, kind of humorous to at least keep you going, especially on the Nintendo Switch, where it's not trophy or achievement based, you know, to keep you wanting to grind and do those wild replayable moments.
Yeah, you know, I really do kind of wish we had something like achievement wise.
For years, I've heard that they were going to allow us to sign in with our Xbox Live accounts. Which I haven't used since 2009.
I'm like, what? I mean, I guess it's cool they want to work together, but I mean, whatever. The games are, I guess, what matters. But I do like the trophies.
I've heard that might happen, and then we'll gain access to their achievements. But I, you know, it seems like we should have something like that, and I really would love to, just because the other two big ones have it. Even Steam, you know, Steam is huge, and they have trophies, they have achievements. Give us a little something to work towards for all those crazy, awesome, again, replayable moments.
There you go, my man. This game that I reviewed today, I gotta tell you, it's unlike anything else that I think I've covered here on the show, and that is Left Right the Mansion. Really unique type of game, I think. This game's only $3.99 on the eShop, which is a crazy, crazy deal. Let me hit you with a little bit of the synopsis. A unique hand-drawn memory game. Left Right the Mansion is a little game about a boy, Billy, whose dog named Gigi ran away inside a big mansion. He must journey through this mysterious place where he will have time to find and remember the right path in order to find her. Every room will challenge him with a simple choice, left or right. Two doors, yet only one will make him go forward. The other will bring him back to the beginning with a really creepy monster. Left and Right is a memory game filled with strange creatures and scary bosses who will try to stop Billy from finding his dog. It's a pretty simple, fun 2D game inspired by the old classic games, for which even after all these years, we still remember the button sequences to avoid the punches or get 30 lives. The human memory is a very fascinating thing, and Left Right is here to test its limits. Will you be able to fight Billy, help Billy find Gigi, or will she be trapped forever in this crazy mansion? Enjoy! This game is only for one player. They say that it's a puzzle game, and it's in, like, every shop. it's all over the world, I guess, because there's really not, you know, a ton of dialogue in this game, and they really kind of harp on the fact that it is hand-drawn. The graphics in this game, like, or the drawings in this game are awesome. I feel like they really play into, you know, the spooky, creepy factor. Kind of looks a little bit Tim Burton-esque. Like if there was like a Tim Burton-esque like kid storybook, that's what it looks like. And they, you know, they describe it very well, because you are either going left or right. You're going in one door or you're going in the other door. And then once you kind of traverse your way through the mansion to get to one of the bosses, you have to fight them in a sequence of whether you're going left or right. And that's it. That's all there is to it. I played this game with my son. He thought it was pretty cool. It is, you know, it, they base it, they say it's a memory game, but like in order to get to like
the boss or one of the bosses, because there's multiple in this game, you have to like enter or go through a series of doors throughout the mansion, which is cool because each room looks a little bit different, and it's like turning the pages like a really well illustrated children's book, which is probably why he was drawn to it, because it looks like a kid's book. But you know it's memory. So you have to, like, you know, if you go the wrong way, then you start over. So we did kind of, like, bust out some, like, a pen and paper to, like, write down the path so we knew where we were going. It was cool because I can't remember the last time that I had to, like, do something like that with a game. Although maybe Destiny, when I had to write out, like, our code that we had to type in for, like, 30 lines. But this is similar because you're going either left or right and you're going down some long hallways. And especially once you get to those boss fights, you don't want to have to go back. Luckily, it's not random. So could you imagine if it was randomized where every time you turned the game on and you had to, like, you know, press the buttons differently? So you know, if you know how to beat the level, you can definitely remember it and beat it if you have that type of memory. I don't, which is why I need the pen and paper. But I like this, man. This is a simple, cool little game. The graphics are, the drawings are awesome. I always seem to get into most of the hand-drawn stuff. It just looks different than, you know, the stuff that we're normally used to seeing. The fact that this is spooky without being too crazy spooky, this is definitely a game that you can play with the younger ones, and for $4 even, like $3.99, that's a deal and a half, my guy. 4.25 for Left Woo! Right the Mansion. Yeah, it's up there.
How about it, ladies and gentlemen?
And different. Unlike anything else.
Yeah, I always love it when you get to experience games and you're... Because I feel like you, more often than I, will have these experiences where you're like, I've never tried a game like this before, and I'm genuinely enjoyed it. It's not my bag, but maybe it is. But that's always fun, because
the point of this show, ladies and gentlemen, a little bit, is that we do switch it up. He with his style of horror-based FPSs, and me with my... microwave cookery. My bejeweled, I guess, would be what I pretty much do all the time.
You like a puzzle game, that's fine.
I do. I have a good time with a puzzle game as well as a platformer. Hey, you know, I get around. But what do you get around to, ladies and gentlemen? Get at us. We're at PreachCast, at Preach Network, over on the YouTube. I'm at Seth Trev. He's at From the Cribbed, and together we make up the Switch It Up show. And we got to remind you that if things ever get boring, you can always switch it up.